pani nirbala e jive tai pani nirbala rokya janda
The Asiatic lion had once roamed a territory extending from the Mediterranean Sea to the Bay of Bengal. But by the beginning of the 20th century, there were only a dozen or so left. The Nawab of Junagadh, a princely state in Gujarat, was a great lover of animals and extended his patronage to the protection of this critically endangered cat. Over time, this small population of lions grew to be one of India's greatest conservation success stories. But experts feared that this success might be short-lived. A single epidemic like canine distemper could wipe out all the lions in Gir. A second home was needed.
Well, the lion translocation, the idea of lion translocation was not new when I got into the field. It has been an idea that's been around for some time because it's fairly simple conservation logic. It is not rocket science for people to recognize that if you have all your eggs in one basket, it's not good policy. And in the mid-late 1950s, actually an attempt was made to translocate lions from Gir to Chandra Prabha in Uttar Pradesh. And for a variety of reasons, for a short time it succeeded, but in the long term it failed.
Agra is a wholly unremarkable village in central India. Until the year 2000, did not have an all-weather road servicing it. That was about to change. The villagers of Agra woke up one morning in 1998 to find their forest being clear felled by bulldozers. They were about to receive new neighbors, 6,000 of them. Several Saharia villages were being moved from their traditional homes along the Kuno River. A second home had been found for the lions.
I initially came here to, animated by this belief that the conservation project that's happening in Kuno is an important project because the lions are, the Asiatic lions are an endangered species. On the other hand, I was also fairly convinced that if the villages which are moving out are given a raw deal, then that would be an injustice in the name of the environment. That is not acceptable. So I came looking for ways in which this whole dilemma of trying to do socially just wildlife conservation could be resolved.
The survey addressed three sites, Sita Mata and Dara in Rajasthan, Kuno in Madhya Pradesh. And by a long shot, Kuno was the best site. Well, when you translocate animals, you first of all want sites to have been part of its former distribution. Fortunately, all three were. Kuno, primarily because of its large size, not just the wildlife sanctuary, but the forested tract was about 3,500 square kilometers of forest. So this is not some toy kind of experimentation. You're looking at it as a project which will survive 100, 200 kind of years, and you're looking at fairly large population, 70 to 80 animals, adults. So you needed space. Sita Mata kind of met that, but had a fairly low prey density. Kuno also had a prey density problem, but the size of the forest tipped it in its favor.
What I realized increasingly when I began working in this area is that this whole idea of a forest itself is problematic and can be contested. For instance, the Kuno Wildlife Sanctuary itself was notified in the year 1981. The people living in this area have lived there for generations before that and were not just hunter-gatherer Adivasi people, but had fertile land along the banks of the Kuno. A lot of that land they had title holdings too, so in that sense it wasn't a forest. It was, patches of good quality forest interspersed with lots of agricultural land. And it's only when the boundary of the Kuno Sanctuary was decided in 1981 with its notification that all the land inside it began to be considered as a forest or a wildlife sanctuary. It was not. It was farmland. In fact, many of them have pattas to that land and have had them for, you know, a few generations. So the whole idea that the sanctuary is an inviolate sort of wild area that needs to be restored to its prior inviolate state is itself an idea that reality sort of conflicted with.
जो पालपुर से आगे था जो उमरी लाद लार्ज है ना उसे रोड में पड़ते खेती करते खेती किसान
कुछ और करते
नहीं और कुछ नहीं करते खेती करते
यू नीड लुक एट इट At least two ways. One is what is the impact of wildlife on people, and what is the impact of people on wildlife. In some sense, India is hugely appreciated by the international community for our considerable success in conserving wildlife, biodiversity in all its forms. Despite the challenges that we have 1.2 billion human population, rapidly urbanizing and changing, increasing demands of nature, to a large extent still rural, land-based, biomass-based economy. But still, you go into some parts of this country, both within and outside protected areas, you have spectacular landscapes, you have wonderful wildlife.
कई बार आता है इस रास्ते से निकल जाता है पैर मिलते हैं वो जहे आते हैं जहाँ रास्ता है निकलेगा तो गाय डर पे डर भी लग जाते हैं बातें आप होती हैं यहाँ तक हमारी गाय बैठी होंगी तो हम भें अपने बाह में तो बितक में टिके भी लग जाएंगे हैं वो निकल रहते हैं दुआ से तो ये हम समझ जाते हैं कि कोई ना कोई जा रहा रास्ता फिर आवाज कर देना हल्ला कर देना वो निकल जाते
वी कैन नॉट स्वीप द प्रॉब्लम्स अवे कॉन्फ्लिक्ट इज ह्यूज एंड कॉन्फ्लिक्ट डजंट नेसेसरली मीन इंजरिंग किलिंग पीपल इट कुड जस्ट मीन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ अ लार्ज एंड डेंजरस एनिमल इन योर नेबरहुड व्हिच इन सम सेंस प्लेसेस अ कर्फ्यू ऑन योर एक्टिविटी एंड मच ऑफ रूरल इंडिया हैज टू गो आउट टू डिफिकेट एंड यू नो सिंपल एक्ट्स ऑफ लाइफ कैन गेट कंस्ट्रेंड बाय दिस काइंड ऑफ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट There are, of course, far more serious in terms of economic terms and security terms where livestock is lost or crops are lost, buildings are damaged, people are injured, people are killed. So large dangerous animals and people are a reasonably toxic mixture. And that needs to be recognized both by conservationists as well as by people... The lobby which is supporting human rights and tribal and so on and so on. I don't think the facts of the matter should be forgotten.
एक बार ये अपनी गाड़ी आई नहीं उधर से इस रास्ते में ली भाई ये बच्चा खा लिया हमारा तेंदुआ नहीं पानी पी गए तालाब में तैयार ही हमारी गाड़ी हम भैं छोड़े के आए गए मन नहीं चलो भैं खराखाई पे चले चाय माए बनाएंगे और बस जय आए हम तेरी गाय जोते दोई दई तो हमने दे गई पाई समार करी ते वो बच्चा नहीं फिर दे वो दे भैं कबाड़ डरो बाजी बते हैं दिया
I think in several situations people and wildlife can coexist if the costs are recognized and accepted. You cannot have a situation where every time there is a human injury or a human fatality, the answer is to then kill the animal or remove the animal. But at the same time, we cannot be hands off and say, but those people are living there and that's the cost of living. I think there has to be compassion in dealing with that situation.
सौ रन था करने परंगे फॉरेस्ट वाय नो इन्हें बाघ और ऐसे शेरा खबो बताओ पहल दवा और फिर शेरा की पाए बताओ के शेरा को चिन्ह बताओ के कहाँ खाइए कैसे पकड़ी और से तो हाल ही मारे भज जाते फिर काय हो शेर अब फॉरेस्ट वाय ने कहाँ बताया
The legal framework of this country has changed quite a bit since the Forest Rights Act has been implemented. So forest dwelling communities have rights under that act. Those rights have to be given to them to begin with. And then you move things forward. Of course, Kuno, the relocation of people happened way before the Forest Rights Act came into way. And on, let me say this also that we fought and got a much more generous financial package for those families than what was the norm. Saying it is a special case, large numbers of people are going to be moved, and we tried to the extent possible to work with the government as a long-term basis rather than, okay, their money is paid, our responsibility is over.
The process was not very well thought out in the sense that, firstly, the land that the people were given was of an extremely poor quality, especially when compared to the land they had inside. Inside, they were along the banks of the river Kuno or perennial streams that fed the Kuno. And this was land that they had farmed. It had deep soil. And when that population was brought here, basically a lot of what you see around you here was all fairly degraded forest land. And this was clear felled to resettle these people. So it was a lottery whether you got good quality land, bad land, whether it had soil depth or not. So for a farming people to be brought out and given a much lower grade land required lots of very terrible backbreaking adjustments.
जमीन जो बंजर जमीन थी वैसी जैसी बनी नहीं जमीन पेड़ खड़े जो पेड़ जो डोजर से रेंसाए गए नहीं वो उनकी सफाई करी और जो पिलाव मतलब से जोते दो तीन साल में मतलब ठीक कर पाई साफ कर पाई जमीन में
तो बहते उठे विस्थापन भाव हम तो है आके जंगल डरो धरती जी पूरी साफ नहीं बिल्कुल तो कम से कम छह महीना इसमें लग गए सफाई में खंडा भी नहीं फिर कम से कम पांच छह ट्रॉली तो खंडा बीन ले ओ, ताके बाद में फिर जो तो फिर पानी नहीं बसो पसंद नहीं वो है पथरीली जमीन फिर चले गए पूरा विस्थापन में बामे चेंचुरी में काम कर भी गए चेंचुरी में फिर मजूरी लाते तब मोड़ा मोड़ी में पेट पूर्ति पाते अब बस ऐसे ही है तरह फिर कत रहे पांच महीना कब आऊ चार महीना कब आऊ ऐसे मेहनत कत रहे जिनमें फिर कुआ खोद लो इसमें कुआ में पानी नहीं है तो फसल कैसे करें
पानी की समस्या जो पानी जो खेतों में का है जो जिन लोगों ने ज्यादा मेहनत करी है इन्हें पानी कर लो खेतों में और जो ज्यादा परेशानी उन्हें अभी तक नहीं कर पाए पानी
द फॉरेस्ट इनसाइड कुनो वाज यू नो इट प्रोवाइडेड पीपल विद अ रेंज ऑफ थिंग्स फॉर देयर हाउसहोल्ड रिक्वायरमेंट्स यू वॉक इनटू अ सहरिया होम इनसाइड व्हेन दे वर लिविंग इनसाइड एंड यू वुड फाइंड दैट मोस्ट ऑफ हाउसहोल्ड आर्टिफैक्ट्स वर मेड आउट ऑफ समथिंग कलेक्टेड फ्रॉम देयर नेचुरल सराउंडिंग्स इट वाज फार फ्रॉम द मार्केट And you used what you had. It was also fairly tough living, but there were compensations in the form of abundance and familiarity. Outside, since the land was clear felled to make agricultural plots, natural resources were very scarce and they didn't really have even basic things like fuel, wood, water, etc. So, in fact, a lot of people didn't bring their cattle out. And in fact, their cattle being the main reason why they were displaced and they didn't bring the cattle out. The cattle stayed inside, they came out and it was a time of fairly severe hardship for them.
Mm-hmm. पानी की व्यवस्था नहीं थी है। कुछ अंदर वहीं पुराने गांव पे ही छोड़े आए तो जो बाहर के लोग उनको ले गए मवेशी हैं जो हमारे यहाँ से वहीं छोड़े आए। जैसे जो इधर बेड़ार साट के और उधर से ही पूरा साट के वो लोग आँख ले गए वहाँ से मवेशी।
पहले ज्यादा चैंचुरी को वो नहीं हो फॉरेस्ट वाले को तो जानवर ही मार लेते चीतल हिरन नील गाय खरगोश से ऐसे पेड़ पुती होती सब्जी खरीदता नहीं है वो ही सब्जी बनती। अब तो फार्मी मुर्गा मिलता है बस और कुछ नहीं मिले।
So the other major changes that happened were to what in resettlement literature is referred to as the host village. So Agra, where we are sitting right now, was an unwilling host to around 6,000 people who were coming out and migrating and settling around them, which meant that the land that they used to use for collecting fuel wood and grazing their livestock and collecting various forest produce and also for worship and various other things was just cut into private plots and given by the government to the resettlers. So they lost a lot of livelihood. There was conflict between the resettlers and the people of Agra. And it meant hardship which was uncompensated because Agra stayed where it was. This village wasn't a displaced village. So they had neighbors who were being given all kinds of attempts were being made to resettle them, provide them with facilities, whereas their loss didn't really get noticed.
Kachu nengyo. Dangai. Dangai jibag paari jinte, jinale te danga lag rahi jate na chara bagala. Aate ji palpur basra, pera basra, taame dangai danga jame, puri me. Puri me dangai. Sapa nara bhagi rahi te jinte. शीतल रहते साबर रहते सगु रहता और जिगाम आए तब ते कचु ना रहा जो डांग पूरी है ते लगा के है ना पैर आप ते लगा के नो जो डांग न ध्यान गए जो न ध्यान है पाने डांग उतर डांग आई जो सगा डांग आई पूरी
चंचुरी बारे नहीं घाटी डांग तो तुम्हारी बे मशीन हाँ बिनते चोरी भाई डांग वैसे होती है तुम्हारी बेज डर बेचले ते बेचले तेने सफाई करिए डांग। सफाई करे करे कहते हैं सब सातों जाते को ऐसी जमीन करे कहें जोते जोते कहें रूम का फेंक फेंक के समय इतने का सामो पहन राधा सामो पहन आते नाने भाई नो के मैं तो एक वैसे ही चूती आदमी हूँ तुम वही पूछे तो भगवान जाने हाँ और मैं मो पहते का बना
पहले पहले मैंने को जिसमें दाव हम लकड़ी लाते आव का तो जाते आव का तो लेके बजे आते लकड़ी में अब मैंने को कुछ सुविधा ना है जिगाम आ गए थे मैं लकड़ी ने को भुगत रहे घासा कूरे को पहाड़ी ने में तो घासा कूड़ा लाते नहीं है मजने में तो घासा कूड़ा काटते पहले उनको परेशानी आ गई है बहुत लकड़ी ने की शक ये है ये पत्थर मैं गांव में मिले ने अब जिनने बनाए कहते पत्थर मिलेगा तो बनाए मेरे को पत्थर बाबा का जान नहीं दिया खुल कहाँ थे ना आए पत्थर है लकड़ी ने को खा ले आ जाएंगे तो बाबा में चौकी बन जाएगी तब मेरे को लकड़ी नहीं लान देंगे जला दे तो लकड़ी नहीं लान देंगे है कुलाई इन महीने पकड़ लेते हैं हम का करेंगे फिर तुम्हें क्यों भाई साहब का करें मैंने को बहुत परेशानी आ रही है और बाहर में बैठे हैं ऐसा और जगह में नहीं आए तब मैंने कोई परेशानी नहीं गोंद ले आते लगाते पीछे लाए को चले जाते तो कुछ गोंद लाते तो बाते गोंद बंद सब
As the resettlement started happening, there was a lot more cash flowing in this economy and there were outsiders coming in and setting up shops. Also population density went up and as a result it became sort of central place for all the resettlers as a marketplace. And the power dynamics essentially were that, you know, people who were relatively more powerful were able to leverage the presence of the resettlers and the flow of cash in ways that then made them richer.
जे के पहले हम दो कीमती ते लाते पैसा उठाके बनी यानी कहते अब मैंने को पांच कीमती ते पैसा मिल रहा हूँ कहाँ पादा मिलेगा है पादा मिलेगा मैंने को कचू और बित्ता बिन्ने तो पूछ जाते हैं बिस्ता पाने के मन्ने को पूछ रहा है मैंने को बाप को बनी अब उधार ना दे नंगा हुआ तो ले जाओ और नहीं हुआ तो मत ले जाओ आप घर बैठे मैंने को तो दे देते बिस्ता पाने वाले ने को पर मैंने को दे रहा हूँ कचू ने
People started shops to sell liquor and a variety of other market-based activities started happening, which really resulted in a much more unequal. So my work has also shown that income distribution in this place became far more unequal. And the gains that went, the gains and the possibilities of, you know, creating wealth largely went to people who were already powerful. Whereas those who were at the bottom of the rung didn't really gain. In fact, they lost access to their natural resources and their ability to expand agriculture to newer areas also went down because what used to be forest for them now became title-held agricultural land for the resettlers.
पहला तो ऐसी खेती आई ते जंगलों तो बहनों कर लेते के बहन ने तिली करना है के बाजरों करना है कचू करना है ता रूं का काटे के बहन करनो हाँ अब का है ते अब तो इते करेगा ये तो इते का मैं करनो है इता ना जानो ना अच्छी
the relatively more influential villagers within Agra actually found new ways of, you know, the forest now, the forest near them has receded, the boundaries of the forests have receded, it's at least a couple of kilometers walk away. The level of policing inside the forest is variable, it depends on who you are, how much of a boundary, how much of a real boundary of that forest exists. So the relatively more influential people who have relatives among the forest, lower forest bureaucracy, actually manage to take their cattle into the reserve forest, have cattle camps for a few months, which then produce milk and ghee and various other things, which are then sold in the market. So I find that essentially this whole process has resulted in, you know, number one, environmental justice has got compromised because people had relatively more equal access to the forest, which now is differential access.
अब जहाँ मैं जो अगर आके हैं और जाए बाद में बाहर दूसरे इलाके के आ जाए तो भी तो चाहे जहाँ पर मवेशी ले ही जा रहे हैं प्रयागर आके और जो अपने घर ने त्यो माने बिन की परेशान है जो अट्ठा इसे काम आए हैं हमारी जमीन बने में गई है जंगलों में बिन में खत्म है वो और फिर बाहर के आगे जाओ चराए तो हमारी मवेशी तो भूखी ना मरे जमीन हमारे पे कम है क्योंकि ये गाँव ने चली गई अब बड़ी हवाई जी गाँव नहीं आए तो हमारी 15 बीघा जमीन ही जा 100 रबा की 10-15 बीघे आंसू की नदी के किनारे पे अब बुझे नहीं हो गई जी गाँव ने फॉरेस्ट वाले ना परेशान करते बाहर रखे और फिर हैं हम ये कुलाई हो चाह तो मैं ताम में बैठो टेढ़ो डरो होगा तो टेढ़ो ही रहेगा हमारी में और खटिया आए हैं मोल लेनी है हमारे घर लोहा के पलिंग बनवा लेंगे अगर हमें जो हाथ ने इन्हीं के ज्यादा खटिया मटिया नहीं मिलेंगी पलिंग लोह के डबल बैठे ऐसी व्यवस्था मिले और जो पसीने और बाहर रखे आते हैं काट ही डांगा जिनने और भरी अपने घर बहुत बड़ी बड़ी बल्ली भारी नुकसान जंगल है बहुत काट ने रावत आते बाहर रखी थे तीन ने नो फॉरेस्ट वाले पुलिस वाले नो बजा में अब की इन्हें पहले कह तो घी पी ले लो गो नहीं बजा रहे मैंने कही यार मैं नहीं ने बजा मैंने दो ही कने फोन लगा फिर यार रेंज पे गए हम रेंज पे को नहीं मिले और ये डिप्टी रेंजर आदिवासी ताते कहियो मैं तो जानते नहीं हूँ को रेंजर है खा मैं वो तो कोई नहीं है यहाँ और चाचे फिर मैंने सोपरा फोन करो ये सी सी एफ है अधिकारी होता है बड़ा सी सी एफ को और जिन्हें डी एफ कर फिर बिना ही नहीं ऐसी तेरी कदी माने ऊपर ते आदि साहब ब्याह गाड़ी आए ते सट बिड़ा दे बजे नहीं दे नहीं बजा रहे बदम सोचते फॉरेस्ट वाले पर हमारे पैदे ना तो घी मांगे ना बजाए भी के बढ़िया रह रहे हैं और प्रेम माने प्रेम बार में है घी पानी बह दया नाने पर है आए तो पाल्टी माल्टी हम दे अब दरु आज ही बढ़िया वे माने हम ने बिनते कई कि मन सा जैन दो चार दिन में गाड़ी ले जाओ घुमा ले जाओ करो गस्त ले जाओ करो ब्याह तो फिर मैंने बिना पाल्टी दी 2 किलो घी के बढ़िया लड्डू बाटी बनवाया बिना खबर मारा नहीं कोई दबाव नहीं है मैंने पहले कहू को दबाव
So there are some people who've moved out completely and can't go back, except occasionally, whereas there are others who are routinely going inside, using the forest for livestock grazing, for collecting fuel, collecting timber for household purposes, but you need to have connections to be able to do that. The others have just coped by moving more towards the cities and towards areas where they can become wage workers. There are, of course, people in between who leverage the situation depending on opportunities.
अचराज दे का बारी रे साधु भाई अचराज दे का बारी जिंदा तो हो गया बिना भोजन बलदारी मर के भी फिर जिंदा रे हो गया बिना भोजन बलदारी